Hello everybody, Wild Bill for America here. As a former law enforcement officer, I'm a little bit boggled at what appears to be two systems of justice in the USA. There's the regular justice system that all citizens are supposed to be subject to, but there appears to be a totally separate system for Washington, D.C. VIPs. Hillary Clinton is a good example. She knowingly and intentionally destroyed evidence by wiping her email server clean after being put on notice that those emails were evidence. Now, in every jurisdiction I've ever worked in, tampering with evidence or destroying it is a crime punishable by arrest and jail time. Hillary, in all her arrogance, snidely quipped that she turned over everything that was pertinent. Well, guess what? The defendant is not the one who gets to decide what's evidence and what is not. I think it's time for Trey Gowdy to get back to his roots as a prosecutor. In a criminal case where the subject of an investigation knowingly and intentionally destroys evidence, the prosecutor goes to the grand jury seeking an indictment. Once the grand jury decides that there's enough evidence to try that person, an arrest warrant is issued, and law enforcement officers arrest the person and book them into the local jail to await trial. Don't you think it's about time for Hillary to get a taste of justice? Just last week, I was talking with Sheriff Mack about IRS abuses and how local law enforcement could be a very effective tool to rein in federal corruption. The IRS has a nasty habit of seizing money and property from citizens and then refusing to return it even after charges are dropped or never even filed. That constitutes felony theft in every jurisdiction in America. Sheriff Mack agreed with me that we need to find some fire-breathing prosecutors, perhaps with political intentions, who will take action against the IRS, take them to the grand jury, get that indictment and warrant, and then send the sheriff to arrest and book the offending IRS agents into the local jail to be held for trial. Sheriff Mack smiled and said, it'd be even more effective if we had 100 sheriffs do the same thing in one day. That would send shockwaves through the arrogant Washington, D.C. gang who think that the laws only apply to us little people. Now, I've watched those congressional dog and pony shows where congressmen haul villains before them for a televised hearing, and about all we ever get is a few good one-liners shown on YouTube. We've watched Hillary Clinton, Eric Holder, Lois Lerner, and John Soskinen arrogantly defy Congress, and nothing ever seems to get done about it. Well, there's more than one law enforcement agency in this nation, and any time a crime is committed against a citizen, the law enforcement agency in that person's home city usually has authority to investigate and take appropriate action. I think it's time to turn the local cops loose on the dogs of the federal government. And as an added bonus, when Hillary is arrested, get it on video, put it on pay-per-view. Might make enough money to give the military the pay raise that Obama took and lavished on the criminal trespassers from Mexico. The USA once set a national goal to put a man on the moon, and we did it. Today, the goal is to get Hillary Clinton's booking photo. One small step for a prosecutor, one giant leap for American freedom. This is Wild Bill for America. Thank you for watching, and America bless God again.